And now we're going to learn about one of the greatest features, not only in QuickBooks Online, but in any accounting program anywhere. Did you know that QuickBooks Online has the ability to attach any file in the computer to a transaction that you're saving? That's right. Any type of file that's in the computer that would remind you of the transaction, or at least clarify the transaction later, you can attach to the transaction when you save it. This way, when you reopen the transaction, you can look at the file and benefit from the information from the file that you save with that transaction. You can attach any type of file to any transaction, but usually you want to attach the source document so you can open the file attachment list and manage your documents very easily. Now, usually, for practical purposes, the file that you usually attach to a transaction is usually a picture of the source document of that transaction. And in our case, most of the time, the source document will be a paper receipt that comes out of the machine after you swipe your card. But it doesn't have to be. If it's an invoice, you can take a picture of the invoice or bill and save it with the transaction. In fact, it doesn't have to be a picture at all. It could be a video file that reminds you of information you will need to remember about that transaction later. As long as the file does not exceed the current file size limit, you can upload it and save it with the transaction right from the transaction window. Now, there's only one piece of bad news. You cannot save a file with a transaction if you're originally recording that transaction in the register window. In order to save a file or a picture of the receipt, which is what it normally is, to the transaction, you will have to record that transaction in the transaction windows that we just learned about and not the register. Now, that's because the register window does not have an icon that you can click on that allows you to upload the file to your QuickBooks Online and save it with that particular transaction. But the transaction window does. If you look at the bottom of the deposit window or the check window, you will see a little paperclip icon. And that's the place to click for QuickBooks Online to open up your computer and look into the folder structure of your computer to help you find the file that you would like to upload and save with that transaction.
You could install the QuickBooks Online app on your phone and upload it from there, or you can email it to yourself and download it from the cloud, or you can plug in your phone to your computer with a USB wire and copy it that way.
So all you have to do when you have a transaction is take a picture with your phone of the source document of that transaction. And again, it's usually just a little paper slip that prints from the card swiper after you swipe your card. And once you take a picture, all you have to do is get that picture from the phone to your computer so that you can upload it and save it with the transaction that it goes with. Now, it's very easy to get the file from your phone to the computer. You could email it to yourself as an attachment, or you could upload it from your phone to some storage drive where you could then download it into your computer so that you can save it in QuickBooks Online. For example, let's imagine this is a picture of the receipt from the card swipe for the February 16th transaction that we had with Staples when we purchase supplies. Just go along with it, play along and pretend that this is a picture of the receipt for that particular transaction. Let us also imagine that a picture of this receipt is already in a folder in my computer. Let's take a look at how we would reopen the February 16th transaction and then attach this receipt to it so that if we ever needed to look back at the receipt, it would always be there, saved with the transaction. So now here we are back in the register window for Serena's bank account. And let's scroll down to the transaction in question. And we remember from prior videos, if we double click anywhere in these two lines, we will reopen the data fields for that particular transaction and we can change anything we want. But notice, there is no place to click in the register in order to upload a file. In order to be able to do that, we would have to click here on this edit button and QuickBooks Online would bring us to the original transaction window of entry, which in this case is the expense window. Now, all we would have to do is scroll all the way down and click this button, upload from this device. Now, it used to have, the expense window used to have the little paper clip that I showed you a moment ago. And the deposit window has the little paper clip, but this changed into this little button that I can click on because it would not torment you properly the way a good program should if it didn't continuously change the name of the things you have to click on. So let's be tormented the way it wants and click upload from this device. Now, once you do that, QuickBooks Online is looking through the folder structure of whatever computer you're sitting in front of. So I'm going to click desktop and I'm going to go down to folder 15 where I have all the files for this particular video and double click to open it up. And okay, here it is. There it is. Double click. And now you can see it uploaded this file as an attachment. Which means if I ever want, click yes to save it or it won't save it. But if I ever want to see that attachment or see any information about this transaction, click in either of the two lines to reopen, click edit to go back to the original window of entry. And now when I click show existing, I can click preview and get a picture of the file that I uploaded with that particular transaction. It's that easy. Now, another great thing about this feature is that QuickBooks Online has a separate window with a list of every single file attachment that you ever uploaded to this account in QuickBooks Online. And when you see the files you uploaded, unfortunately, you will not know which particular transaction they were saved with, but you can open them and download them from the list. So let's see together how this works. If we click in the cog wheel and go over to the column of lists and go down to the center where it says attachments, we can click and we get the window that shows a list of every attachment we ever uploaded in the history of this particular QuickBooks Online account. Now, of course, in this case, there's only one, but what we can do is view it and download it if we want. Unfortunately, there's no place to click to determine which transaction was saved with this file. But what you can do is you can click download and it will open in a different window. See, if I lower the browser, you'll see this is the original QuickBooks Online. And when I click download, it opened the file as a picture in another window. Now, all you have to do is right click, save image as, and you can choose which particular folder you would like to save the attachment in. Okay, Now, if I choose, for example, folder number 16, I can click on it and I can name it Receipt Downloaded, enter. And now it's in that folder. So this is a handy tool that will help you. It's a real game changer. You'll always be able to open the proof of that transaction right from the transaction itself. But there's a couple of important points that I want to close with, and I want to give you the benefit of my experience regarding this issue. What I found regarding my clients over the decades is that it's very difficult to get business owners to remember to save every card swipe receipt that they've ever had for every transaction. Most people in business are really busy and they really don't have time to make sure that every little card swipe they ever did has a receipt that's described and filed. However, it is necessary. What I found from my experience is that nowadays, people don't bother with the little paper receipt because they depend on the final statement that gets printed out from either the bank or the credit card company, and they point to the line item on the statement and they say, there's the proof of the transaction. Now, of course, that's some level of proof, but that's not really the best evidence. The best evidence of a transaction is the slip that came out of the card when you swipe the card. Now, ironically, I found that more often than not, people will save the slips and the receipts when they charge on their debit card, but when it comes to credit card swipes, they're more likely to rely on their financial institution and wait to get the credit card statement before either recording the credit card transactions or at least claiming some proof that the credit card transactions actually happen. That is the worst thing you can do. The whole point of getting the slip is so that you can compare it with the statement that the credit card company gives you to check if the charge is legitimate. So if you don't save the slip and you just say, I'll wait until I get the credit card statement and record your credit card transactions from the statement, do you know what that's like? That's like asking the fox to guard the hen house. That's like asking the elephant to pass around the peanuts. That's like asking the burglar to install and manage your house alarm. That's like asking the drug addict to guard the medicine cabinet. Yes, the point is that the very people whom you're trying to protect the records from are the very people whom you're relying on for the records. In other words, it's your job as the bookkeeper to make sure that the credit card statement is accurate. And the only way to make sure that the credit card company did not add an invalid charge that shouldn't be there or charge you for something that they shouldn't is to make sure that you compare everything on the credit card statement to every slip from every transaction that you charge. Otherwise, you don't have proof against the credit card company if they put something on your statement that should not be there. So the file attachment feature will always help protect you as long as you remember to save your receipts and upload them to QuickBooks Online.